politics watch. This is Serbi. Now today I'm going to talk about the incident that took place in St. Elizabeth again, right, where a member of the security company, Guardsman, lost his life. A man by the name of Anthony Endem, right, was a 50-year-old man. Right. Reports said that them pull up, right, them a give them routine, right, drop off, cash drop off, and it's like as them step out of the vehicle, the man him ambush them. As I said, Anthony Endem lost his life. Two other members of the team were injured, right, but it looked like they were going to make it. Right. Let me just say this. This happened all too often in Jamaica. A man get up like any other morning, gone to him work, gone do him job, and he will never go home to his family ever again. You see, because so much things happen in Jamaica and so fast, it's easy to forget so we talk about people. Right? When you hear, oh, one shot, two shot, three shot, remember, these are people. These are people with family. Right? So more than likely, somebody just lost their father, maybe even their grandfather, he was 50 years old. But too many people, too many Jamaicans who earn an honest living can't just guard them job, right, and make it to a mark in one piece. Now, in this scenario, right, obviously his job was high risk compared to the average citizen. But still, he can do the same thing over and over, right, until one day, here comes trouble. Because he would have probably done the same drop off a million times. But all it takes is one bad day. One bad day, and your family not see you again, especially in that kind of line of work. Just like police, just like JLF, whatever, any of them high risk jobs. Just one bad day. And these men had a very bad day. Now, the reason I'm saying St. Elizabeth again is because you would have seen the video I dropped yesterday with the man them, with the old rifle them, or try getting at the supermarket in St. Elizabeth. And then this could happen at Santa Cruz. I'm wondering if it's the same thing on them. Obviously, I don't know for sure, but them plan one hell of an operation, travel by boat, probably make up their mind and say they're going to get rich that night. Couldn't get into the Chinese supermarket. I feel left. Then this happened. Now, as I said, it could be completely unrelated, but it kind of spooky still. What is happening to St. Elizabeth? That parish used to be so quiet. St. Elizabeth have a special place in my heart. But just like the rest of Jamaica, slowly and surely, the acidity spread faster than the big sea. But one thing I have to realize is that none of the people who carry out these acts in St. Elizabeth don't actually come from St. Elizabeth. None of the Moby 87 them, the Clarendon 87 them, they plan them ups in a Moby or in a Clarendon, and then them go striking at St. Elizabeth, because due to the fact that St. Elizabeth is traditionally a quiet place, this make it an easy target for outside 87s to carry out them operation, because they know, say, for example, in a Moby, you have all kind of team, you have quick response team, right? Police, JDF, always in a Moby, or look out for see any kind of operation like this. You're clearing down them place about St. Elizabeth. Right? It's not as what I say, when you talk about, well, nowhere in Jamaica is really locked down securely, but compared to a Moby or compared to a Spanish town, St. Elizabeth don't really have that much presence with security forces as a lucky down. Right? So at 87 have more freedom to operate in a somewhere like St. Elizabeth than they would in a Moby, a Clarendon, right? Obviously a Kingston or a St. Catherine. And 87 is a take advantage. Even the video that I showed yesterday. Right. even though it was night and it was curfew and the police station they right up the road, the man them there for a good 8 minutes. I tried getting out of the place until them decided to them a left. Right. And that was night. Imagine how much noise them would have make. But the St. Elizabeth is thus, right? Let me say, what was its blessing is now a turn in its curse, which is the fact that it was so quiet, right, and not much should have gone. So now all the eyeballs them are there for just scope out and make sure say that have a change now. That have a change now because clearly 87s are carrying out some serious operations in the parish. Right? Especially places like, you know, your Black River, right? Your Santa Cruz, commercial centers. It'll get out of hand. Now, as I was reading the article and Luke, them say, right, two of them describe it is like they never even get a chance to defend themselves. And that makes sense. Because people are reporting that them see the youth them in the area await for them. Right? Them see two of the suspects them, right? Them describe them, right? It's on loop, right? One of them described as well, to be honest, very vague description, but you know, a typical brown complexion, Afro hair. Next one was slim and dark, but I mean, I don't know what's that going to do if nobody never actually see them, right? As in see them face. But the fact that they did that way means that either they're acting on intelligence, right? As in somebody inside the system, right? Where they might try to target or tell them what time the man them normally come. Or is a case where them study the routine of the guardsman truck, which is also very possible. So because them know, say, the guardsman them are also armed, right? Them know get in a situation where the guard them I get a chance to challenge them, right? Because remember, 87, the last thing 87 want is to get in a shootout. So this is why them ambush them. Because if you read the article, it's an ambush. As them pull up, the man them start shooting. As them come out of the vehicle, the man them start engaging. Right? Because they want minimize, right, the risk what will be against themselves. Right? So by taking out the guardsman them right away, them know they can just grab the money and run. Now the fact that them that get the money, show me say, very likely, one of the guardsmen them did put up some kind of challenge and them just take with himself. You see, them security worker, people need to understand, now Jamaica, security work, right? Especially when you move serious money for these big companies, is just as high risk as police or JDF. Maybe even more, because the average 87 would rather challenge a team of security than challenge, for example, a team of police or a team of JDF. And not only that, it's very unlikely they might just randomly challenge a police, right, unless they have some score to settle, right, or prove some point. Police not traveling millions of dollars, so there's not much incentive. A security guard, right, these armored trucks are traveling millions of dollars, so they have a bigger incentive to go after them. And not only that, the type of weapons the guardman have, right, not equivalent to what the police them have. So in a situation like this, where they're basically walking into an ambush, the main thing them probably can do, right, is to just return fire, get back into the vehicle and take with themselves. Right. That's about it. It's not realistic. Well, as a matter of fact, it'd be downright foolish to expect any security company for dead and a trade blows with 87 longer than they need to, right? In that scenario, it's a case of get back in the vehicle because it's armored, right, and take away yourself. Especially the 87 them are come with rifle. Now, as it relates to catching the people who carry the sword, the odds should be very high. I say should be because I don't know the actual situation on the ground, but this took place, right, in the middle of Santa Cruz, right, and it happened right outside of some prominent business place, which means there should be security footage, there should be cameras. You must can catch the picture of a license plate or something like that. All they need is one thing, and they just need one thing. Right, if you set you up on the right trail, and then the dominoes them start fall. And not only that, I think some of these guardman vehicles, not just guardman, most of them, right, well, at least the modern ones them, none of them have camera on the actual vehicle them. Some of them have camera up on the roof, on the side, in the vehicle itself. So when they watch about the footage, right, as Mr. if they mean you can just get a license plate. Or even just get out the general silhouette of a body, and even if the person now wear a mask but half of them face a show, just something for work, because that's all you need, you know. You just need something to put up on the right part. Plus, when you factor in the different business them, we're supposed to, you know, I keep using the word supposed to, right? Because in a Jamaica, you never know. Right? But business place, yeah, when a busy area like that, should have camera. Right? So when they take with themselves and I jump back in a vehicle and them drive off and turn over here, so camera supposed can pick them up to a certain point. I don't know. I mean, I see people online, as usual, you know, using a lot of hindsight, them should have done this, them should have done that. I don't know what took place. And unless we can see a video that show the play-by-play, it's hard to say them should have this and them shouldn't do that. It's easy. It's easy to do hindsight. Right? That's why it's called hindsight, because it don't go on a reading. You can then say, well, them should have done that. Right? They would have made 1,000 drop-offs. Probably 10,000 drop-offs. Right? And things go smoothly, whereas me say you only need one bad day. Now, I'm going to talk to the security team at Jamaica again. Because you've heard me say this many times. I've talked about security guards in Jamaica many times. Now, for Simple Simon, this part of the video now, what I'm going to go into now, nothing to do with what takes place at St. Elizabeth. As I say, I don't know the circumstances, right? And I don't see no video of nothing. But, security guard in Jamaica said over and over again, some of you are too relaxed. Some security guards in Jamaica act like they don't live in one of the most violent countries on earth. People need to switch on. I understand how routine work, right? And you do something, and you do something, and you do something, and then you get alright. I go there so 10,000 times and nothing happen. I go there so 1,000 times and nothing happen. Every day, just like a police, just like a JDF, every day you put on your archive uniform or your guardsman uniform, whatever the case. No, it might be your last, man. Too many times I've seen security guard, man, especially the one they might do, the drop off and pick up money, just downright slacking. Man, we know they must get some kind of training. Man. And you can see one team pull up and you can see, alright, the way they operate, that's clearly they operate according to them SOPs. Man. And then a next team pull up. Man, and it's like a stroll, they must stroll go look for somebody. The one of the shotty was supposed to cover the next one. He move over here, start down the road. If him see Simple Simone now on short skirt, I don't see him look. And the next one, oh, see him bridging and I heal him. Even if he switch on. Them kind of work, that's serious work. Serious, serious work. I've been outside business places before and me see some of these trucks come to pick up money or drop off, man. More than likely pick up, and if me at the door then pull up and just step past, next one over there saw look, man turning back to me, man. The one who have the shotty turning back to me, next one gone into the store, I'm like, how the man know say I'm not at 87? Who they say I wait pound? Right, for waiting up and take the bag and run gone. Some of the sloppiness I've seen. Right. It's a shame. But I'm saying people need to switch on. Some of the one that work inside the building them, even though they're in plain clothes, right, as I said, I'm walking in a business place, I can instantly spot, okay, that's the guardy, right, him armed. Right. Him over here, so, pan him phone, him over here, so, with him bridging the MC down the road, my local man, like, this is serious, serious work. When him if you switch on, right. Because when it go wrong, it go real, real wrong. Right? I'm say Single Simon, I've added this claim of a Single Simon. Not because I care about Single Simon, but because I don't want the messages in my inbox. Right? Because I realize some people are slower than molasses. So I'm not saying that's what happened. I sent it to it. So they were slacking off or they were doing their job properly. I'm talking in general now. Right? Security guards from a hole in Jamaica. Especially the one they do them high risk job, drop off money and pick up money. You have to be switched on at all times. It's a real shame. Right. Real shame. That man woke up, went to him work, probably tell him woman goodbye later. Probably even tell her where he went for dinner. Right. Then I probably cook and pull on, and he will never come home to eat it. See, men who have them type of work here, yeah? You know, non-flashy, non-fast money type of job. Right? Understand, so Jamaican culture rate them people, yeah? Jamaican culture rate them money. Yeah? When working class people in Jamaica lose them life, there's no fanfare, there's no hoopla, and that's a real shame. But I say condolence to his family. Right. But I'm keeping my ears out because I think we might hear say them youth they get catch. Right. And the youth they will carry out, youth they will try going to the Chinese supermarket. Right. Security forces need to make sure say them end up catch them youth there too, because even though they didn't get access, right, or they didn't gain entry, but them with the firepower they might walk around with, plus the level of planning where them go to, right, for even use boat, right, for get around the curfew and not for drive on the road. Security forces are gonna have a real task on them hand, right, breaking up that syndicate, right. But it has to be done. People need to work with the security forces, right. Because you might see something like this happen, right, to Anthony and them, and you say, well, I saw it go, right. That not nothing to do with me, but tomorrow it could very well be you, and if I know you, it can be somebody where you love and you care about. Let me say, this thing is a national issue. Every well-thinking Jamaican, man, every Jamaican who wish to see the country a better place, even if they live in Jamaica, man, this is all of our problem. Man. This is not just Anthony and them family problem, man. This is everybody's problem. We have to turn on Jamaica. This generation, right, maybe we can't save this generation, but maybe the next. Right. If I even for them. Anyway, there were some videos from the scene after it took place. Obviously, we can't show them because they don't know what I got ready. Right. Patreon squad, before we discuss it, because I forgot to talk about the crowd. Realize when these things happen in Jamaica and the crowd draw, right? We need to talk about the crowd, right? Because I'm starting to realize certain things now with how people behave, right? When empty things like this happen. Anyway, Patreon squad, big up on yourself. Look out for that video in about half an hour time. PIA, you don't know. More life. Vulture squad, stay circling. Bless.